Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And oh, guys, I tried so hard not to act tired, but goddamn, I got asthma. I need to stop doing all that shit, bruh. Today we're gonna be talking about internships. Internships are the key to success after college, okay? And you know why? Because if you do an internship, more than likely, if you do a good job and you didn't intern for an A shit company, they will hire you straight out of college. So, I'm gonna tell you guys some poppin' ass tips to get some internships, and then I'm gonna tell you guys about how my internship tried to sue me, bitch. Sue me. My broke ass. Sue me for what? First of all, I ain't got no motherfucking money. What she gonna sue off me? The motherfucking loans? She gonna sue my loans, bitch? You wanna inherit my loans? But whatever. Let's start. So I actually did talk about this internship in a video a few months ago, but I accidentally deleted the video and I never felt like reposting it again. So ever since that happened, I'm actually being sued now. So I was like, oh shit, new story time. So basically I get to talk shit and then talk shit about how this bitch tried to sue me. Internships. The best way to find internships, no duh, the internet. That is the best place to find anything, guys. The internet, okay? If you guys have a career services place on your campus, which I'm sure most schools do have a career services type situation at the institution, go there. I don't understand. Like, I cannot tell y'all how many times, especially at Bluefield College, people have told me they've never been to career services until like they senior year. Don't be that dumbass. Make sure you go to career services your freshman year and you create and maintain that connection, because they will send you shit, guys. I have a mentor that happens to work in career services. That was just lucky for me. She got paired with me. Like, I love her. She's like amazing. And she literally gave me a lot of opportunities in college, as well as she still continues to send me opportunities to this day. And I'm forever grateful for that, okay? And that's with any department on your campus, especially if it's like something that is close to your major. So if you're a finance major, you better go make friends with motherfucking your financial aid office. They could give you a job when you graduate, okay? If you are an arts major, you better go to your cat building, okay? You better go make friends with everybody in there. That's like that with everything in life, okay? If you're gonna, depending on your major, make relationships with everyone who works in your department or who's close to your thing or anyone who can get you a job. Cause this shit hard out here. It is hard out here for a pimp. Definitely search online for your internships. Next step would be go to your career services, tell them what you need, and they will help you find what it is that you need, and they will usually help you with your resume as well. Shit, even if you don't have clothes for your fucking resume, I know a lot of schools that actually have like a closet for you, and you can actually take stuff from their closet to wear for your interview. When looking for companies to intern for, this is what I noticed is usually the best thing to do. Intern for small companies, okay? Of course, it's, you probably like, damn, I wanna go intern for like Power 105. I wanna go intern for Nielsen. I wanna go intern for VH1. Yeah, bitch, more than likely that shit not gonna happen. It's just not, okay? I'm not gonna tell you it's not, but a lot of times those are like the hardest things to get, especially if you're on the East Coast. It's very difficult to get anything, okay? So interning with small companies gets you the experience you need. It's gonna make sure, they're going to make sure you're not just out running coffee because they're too small and they need the help. And they're also going to make sure that you get real life experience, and they're gonna make sure that you actually go somewhere. Now, if you're going to intern for a small company, do not intern for a small company who will not hire you, okay? Because this is the bullshit that I did. And do not intern for a small company that just needs free help. Now, there's a lot of small companies out there that will just have interns to do work, but they don't do anything for them in return. They don't give them any connections. They don't give them any incentives. They don't connect, they don't hire them. And it's just, sometimes, I'm not even gonna lie, it's a waste of time. I mean, it makes a good connect, but literally if someone's not hiring you, or someone's not giving you that connect to someone who can hire you or will hire you or anything in that way, then it's a waste of time. I'm just telling you that right now. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I know there's probably gonna be a lot of people like,
oh no, anyone can give you anything. You can get experience anywhere. Yeah, I get it. I'm not saying that it's a bad experience. You get the experience. That's the only good part. So it's not a complete waste. You get the experience doing whatever it is. But in the long run, it don't really help you if that person is not connecting you with someone who can hire you or is not hiring you themselves. And that brings me to my fucking story. So I interned for this small company, right? And this company happened to be in Bloomfield, and it was kind of like fairly a new business, but not really a new business. And it was a PR firm, okay? So this PR firm had zero employees. It had one employee, but that employee, she was pregnant, and then she had her kid, and then she left. So it was like only a few of us interns. It was like four or five interns. And then it was the owner, the CEO, wherever the hell she was, right? So honestly, right off the bat, I saw that there was something wrong with this company for the simple fact that she was always not around. Like, for me, she wasn't around because I was the only one that was in New Jersey. All the rest of the interns were New York based. So I was always by myself. And that just irritated me. It's like, bro, like, you have an office space for no reason. Like, I'm the only one who comes here. Like, why are you wasting your money? Like, I honestly, whatever. So basically, yeah, that was my first thing. The fact that it was just empty, there was no other employees. That's the first red flag right there. Second, her equipment was extremely outdated. Like, when I'm telling y'all outdated, like, you know those computers that we first had when we was like in first grade and we was first learning how to type? Yeah, like that. Like, it was that type of shit, except they were a laptop form and they were really bad. They were shitty as hell and they were very, very slow. And then on top of that, the Wi-Fi was trash, because, you know, when I saw the equipment was slow, I was like, oh wow, this is unproductive. Let me just bring my laptop. Let me speed my own production up. Let me not complain. Oh, I bring my laptop, that shit ain't work. Motherfucking Wi-Fi on what the fuck? Motherfucker, Wi-Fi on, bitch, you thought. Bitch, I thought that shit was gonna work, but it didn't. So I'm sitting there and I'm just irritated because it was very hard to get work done when your Wi-Fi is trash and your equipment is trash as well. If you've ever worked on a computer, on a laptop, on an iPhone, on anything, on any type of anything, any piece of technology that's old with bad Wi-Fi, it's like committing suicide. Like, I swear to God, I wanted to die. I wanted to die. And it got to the point where I just started doing certain things like on my phone. Yeah, I had to use Hootsuite in order to manage the company's, you know, social media. So I would just use my phone. Mind y'all, I was like never texting, never doing anything like that, honestly. And it's crazy because, like, my boyfriend at the time, he would always call me and he would be so mad because I wouldn't pick up, because I'm like, no, I'm doing work on my phone. Like, can you stop calling me? Like, it was that crazy. So keep that, guys, keep that shit in mind. There was only probably two interns actually doing work. Okay, like, so another thing that I really couldn't stand was this lady. She gave us tasks, but she gave us all the same task. So she would send out an email every morning and it would say, I need this done, this done, this done, this done, this done. Now, that would be okay if we all worked at the same time and we're in the same place all the motherfucking time, right? But we did not have contact with each other. We never really saw each other. I only saw the other interns about 2 or 3 times. I never saw the other interns like that. So when you send out a list with all these tasks, how are we supposed to know who's doing what and who's done what? How the fuck are we supposed to know? So what would happen is, like, say I'm working on something and I'm thinking I'm doing it right. I'm asking her a question. She's like, oh, such and such already did that. I'm like, bitch, how the fuck am I supposed to know? How the fuck am I supposed to know who did what, when, and where? How? Like, we tried to tell her, like, can you please send individual tasks lists, because that's just mad stupid. She caught a fit. She caught a whole fit. So, like, these lists was the most annoying thing to me. The equipment was the most annoying thing to me. Like, I was just pretty much over it, but I was still one of the only people doing a lot of the work. Me and this other intern, we were doing most of the work, okay? She would work in the morning, and anytime that she would leave, that's when I would come in. So, like, she was there for most of the time, and then I would come and take over. So, literally, we were both by ourselves most of the day. The other interns, they were doing shit, but not really, like, sometimes. Yeah, sometimes they did, but they was over it too, honestly. Like, they was really over it. So, it got to a point where, and like, that's how I know, like, I was one of the very few people doing specific things, like a lot of the work, because at one point we had a spring break, and the spring break was about a week, right? And it's funny because she didn't factor this into my term or whatever, and she had the audacity to add one more week to my internship because I took off for spring break. But it's like, bitch, I'm not even supposed to be working here for spring break. But you know what, I didn't even argue with this lady. I was like, whatever, fuck it. So she basically had this task for me to like do this video slideshow situation for a client. And mind y'all guys, this was like the worst quality thing. Like they went to this client's office, took pictures on an Android and told me to put it in Movie Maker and make it a slideshow with her voice interviewing him under it. It just looked shitty. It was just a terrible job. And that was another thing, like she was out here charging people thousands of dollars, okay, to do mediocre work for them, and that was something I just really didn't like. And I was just like, yo, like I can't wait to get out of this place. Like it was just low quality work. I wasn't a fan of it. But anyways, basically she told me to do this, and like I said, her equipment was trash. I couldn't do it on my laptop. I don't remember why. There was a reason I couldn't do it on my laptop. Oh yeah, the shit just would never send, guys. Like it was so bad. Like even sending emails was like harder than this. It was really bad. So I leave for spring break. I'm thinking, okay, by the time I come back for spring break, somebody's gonna do it, because everybody else was working but me. I was the only one that wasn't working that week. Everybody else's spring break was either the week before or the week after mine. I come back, why that shit still the same? Why that motherfucker's live show still the same way? Bitch. Bitch. How? Houseway. How? And then like she would have these constant. When I'm telling you constant. When I'm telling you constant. Google Hangouts, bruh, freaking meetings all damn day. And it's just like, how many meetings do you need to have? Like, we would have like 3 or 4, and I'm only there for like 5 hours, and these meetings would be anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour long. And then she would sit there and complain to us, oh, you guys need to get your work done faster. And then like she would even do it in person. Like the days when she was in the office with me, which was probably like once or twice a week. No, she was there one day. I was there, I think, two or three times a week, but there was one day where she was definitely there all the time. And she would sit there and try to have full-blown conversations with me. And then she was like, oh, you need to get this done. You need to get this done. I'm like, bitch, stop fucking talking to me then. I'm a very, like, up person. Like, I can't have people talking to me while I'm doing something, because it's going to make me stop what I'm doing. Like, when it comes to that, I'm not good at multitasking. When it comes to actually doing work, it doesn't really work for me. Like, I'm going to have to stop the work and focus on you talking. Like, that's just the way I am. And this lady was constantly trying to talk to me. And it was just like, bro, like, I really don't want to talk to you. Like, I'm trying to get your work done. And, like, for you to catch an attitude when you're the one that's talking to me and I don't want to talk to you. And then she would talk about some, oh, I had a bad attitude and I need to watch my attitude, because in the real world people won't think I'm in a funk. And I'm like, bitch, like, I'm in a funk. Like, yes, because you're annoying. Like, I'm really in a funk right now. Like, yeah, like I'm perfectly fine, but you're really annoying me. 99 problems. This was a very stressful time in my life, guys. Like, a very stressful time. My freaking ex was deployed at the time. I was going through a lot of mental hardship. Like, guys, this was the worst. Like, and then my semester was super duper hard. And I ended up failing my British literature class, because first of all, that class was so fucking hard. And plus, they tried to say that I plagiarized. That's for another video. But guys, it was just so much bullshit, and I just couldn't deal with this damn lady. So it got to a point where, you know what, I was almost done. I was happy as hell. I was like, yes, bitch, I'm out that motherfucking door, right? Let me tell you that bullshit this hoe did to me. There was an intern there with me, okay? Now, we was cool as hell. That was my bitch, okay? I love her. I'm gonna have to text her after this. She hits me up. No, she hits me up and she's like, yo, like, this dumbass bitch is extending my internship so I can train this other intern that's coming in. Now, guys, there was about 5 of us, but all of us were leaving. She didn't have anybody else lined up to work with her after we left. And I'm just like, oh, no. Like, who's gonna train these hoes, like? Cause like we was down to our last week and a half. So she literally extended this other girl's internship so that she can train the other people that are coming in. And I was like, oh hell no, she do that shit to me, I'm fighting. This stupid little heifer hoe. This stupid bitch, son. She goes and she emails my mentor talking about, oh, I'm on my phone too much and it's gonna hinder me and I'm always in a funk and I need to get rid of that funk. And I have a bad attitude. All this shit, mind you, all the while she's being happy in my face all the time. In my face all day, every day. All up in the motherfucking sauce. All up acting like a fake ass bitch. That's the problem. That is the problem. I really hate fake ass bitch. Oh, guys. Guys. But anyways, basically, she's talking all of this shit to my mentor. Literally hits up my mentor and tells her, oh, she thinks that I should spend some extra time. I should extend my internship so I can learn more and I can improve.
No, I was already miserable. I was not having it. My mentor is lit as hell because she told me about this. And I was like, oh, really? Oh, that's what she think. She thinks she about to do that? Well, this ain't that, bitch. This ain't that. One day, I had left my headphones in the office and I had to go over there. And I guess she was trying to talk to me about it. And that shit irritated me because she's like, oh, do you have some time to talk? It's really important. I'm just like, no, like, I'm trying to get my headphones, sis. So whatever, I end up going and she's just like trying to talk to me like I did something. Mind you, y'all, she's never acted different. I don't know what her problem was. I really feel like she just wanted me to stay and train these ancient individuals who I didn't give a shit about. And she's just like,
has been really slow lately and you're always constantly on your phone and like your phone is always blowing up and I don't know if you're doing my work or if you're doing your own work and I just don't really like your attitude lately and I really just feel like you should spend some extra time at the internship so that you can show more improvement.
Bitch, it's not my fault that I'm popping. How is it my problem that my phone is going off? It's not my fault that I'm popping. I've got a lot of followers, which means I'm gonna get a lot of notifications all the time. So I need to understand what you're talking about, sis. We did a lot of assessments throughout this internship. I did about 3 assessments, okay? In all 3 of these assessments, she said I was good across the motherfucking board, okay? The only thing is she did say something about my phone, but it wasn't like, it was very minor. Like, it wasn't that serious. Like, the way she was coming at me was nothing like what she put on that damn paper. So, I'm like, how do you now have a problem with something that you didn't have a problem with about a week ago when you gave me my assessment? How is it that you have a problem when I'm the only one doing your work? My phone is literally always on do not disturb, but when it came to her work, I would put it on do not, like, I would take it off because, like, I would have to accept phone calls from clients and, like, do other shit. Like, I'd have to do stuff on my phone and I would have to pay attention to my phone in order to do her work. So my notifications were definitely coming through there. I really can't stand this lady. So then let's get to the part how a homegirl tried to sue me, right? So basically, I write a review for her company. And basically, I was handing it to her. I was like, this company was terrible. I interned for this. And guys, don't ever do what I did. Honestly, I would not recommend it because, like, you should always keep good contacts with people in your life. But for me, I personally, I'm not a fan of people disrespecting me. So personally, I could care less, and that's just me. But please do not take after me. But I basically wrote a bad review about her company. And then she sent her lawyers on me. Basically, she sent it to my... She didn't even send it to me. That's the funny part. She never sent that shit to me. She sent it to my mentor. And then I got the letter in my house, like at my house. I got the physical lawyer letter. I don't know where it is, honestly. It's somewhere here. I saw it when I packed to go back on back here, back home, but I don't know where it is. So yeah, she sent me a physical letter to my house, but she sent an email of the same letter to my mentor. My mentor called me up, like, please take it down. And honestly, out of respect for my mentor is the only reason I took it down. If it wasn't for my mentor, I don't give a shit. I would have cursed the ass out and been like, I can say whatever the fuck I want, because honestly, that is a Google review. I am reviewing your company. Your company's caca, but whatever. So yeah, the moral of the story is, intern for good companies with good people, with real employees and real integrity. Do not just intern anywhere just because it's an internship. Intern somewhere that you know you're gonna get experience, that you know you can get a job, or you know you get connections from, because it's not worth just going to work or going to intern somewhere that's not gonna get you somewhere and return is not gonna help you progress. Try to keep very good contacts with people that you intern for or people that you work for, because you never know. Cause my ass almost got sued. Like, I really got like a cease and desist order. This shit was funny as fuck. Basically, they told me I had to take the shit down. I was like, you know what? I wasn't gonna take it down, but yeah, if it wasn't for my mentor, I would have to take it down. So if you enjoy that story time, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. If you've ever been about to be sued or whatever the fuck it is, tell me down in the comment section below. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe, and follow me on social media. And I'ma see y'all next time.